Hi, this is Alan Robinson, and welcome to our From List to Sold series. And in this video, we are reviewing multiple and backup offers. In hot markets, it's not uncommon for a seller to receive multiple offers. This situation can result in thousands of dollars of additional proceeds. In this video, I will teach you how to maximize your profit by learning how to handle multiple offers and using backup offers to leverage your negotiations with buyers. Specifically, you will learn 1, what conditions lead to multiple offers? 2, a strategy to solicit multiple offers. 3, how to evaluate offers like a professional. 4, which buyers have the most profit potential. 5, which buyer financing is in your best interest. 6, how to ask for highest and best offer, leveraging multiple buyers against one another. 7, how to use multiple counter offers. 8, how to avoid inspection issues using a backup offer. 9, using backup offers to protect yourself against failed transactions. And we end with 10, escalation clauses. After your home gets listed, you want to solicit more than one offer. Multiple offers can lead to thousands of dollars in additional proceeds. What conditions lead to multiple offers? 1, your home is located in a hot market or hot neighborhood. 2, you have an unusual amenity like our home that fronts Arapahoe Lake. 3, homes in award-winning school districts get multiple offers. 4, beautiful homes. And finally, 5, if your home is underpriced, you will get multiple offers. However, we're not going to focus on this. Let's say you've done your market analysis as you learned in our Crunching Your Numbers Part 6 video, and you live in a hot neighborhood. Homes are flying off the shelf. You'll need a strategy for soliciting multiple offers. You don't want to list your property on day one and accept the first offer that comes along on day two. The following technique is one that many top producers use. You list your property and you advertise in the MLS that you will not respond to any offers for the first 2 weeks. It's very important that your MLS listing have this caveat, so make sure it's done. That's your marketing time. In the first week, you hold a broker open house on Tuesday or Wednesday. These are traditionally slow days for agents. Schedule the broker open around lunchtime and feed them. Look at your home pricing report to get a list of agents that have sold properties in your neighborhood and those with active listings. It should contain the contact info for those agents. Also, hold an open house on each weekend of that 2 weeks and start collecting offers. Before an agent or buyer shows your home, they will often ask if you have any offers in on your home. Most agents and buyers want to avoid competitive situations. Your job is just the opposite. You want to create a competitive situation. You want a potential buyer to emotionally commit by writing an offer. Let me give you some guidance on what to say. You should tell an agent or buyer, "No, we don't have any offers at this time," or my favorite response is, "Yes, we do have an offer in on the property, but it's a lower offer and we're not too excited about it. I think the buyer is an investor." I strongly encourage you to write an offer. Even if you do have multiple offers, you do not have to disclose it. In fact, you shouldn't, at least not up front. You'll disclose it when you ask for highest and best offer. What else can you do to generate multiple offers? Follow the advice in our Section 2 videos on staging, showing, and marketing. Homes that are immaculate in look and function will often get more than one offer. Now let's review how to evaluate offers. When you receive multiple offers, you'll need to know how to pick the best offer, which isn't necessarily the offer with the highest purchase price. I want you to use the following criteria when evaluating multiple offers. The first is occupancy type. Is the buyer an investor or is he planning to live in the property? Next is financing type and money down. Financing type is how the buyer plans to pay for the property. Is he paying cash or getting a conventional FHA or VA loan? As you'll learn, the buyer's down payment is often a function of the financing type. 3 is seller concessions. Is the buyer asking for your help in paying his closing costs? 4 is quickness of close. How quickly can the buyer get to the closing table? Does the buyer want to close in 2 weeks or 1 month? And finally, the number of contingencies in the offer. The more contingencies, the more opportunities for the buyer to cancel the contract and get his earnest money back. Let's review each of these factors in detail, starting with owner occupancy. Typically, buyers planning to live in the property are willing to pay more than investors. That's because an owner-occupant falls in love with a home they are planning to purchase. They become emotionally attached to the property. That's why owner-occupants typically pay thousands more than investors. There is one exception to this rule. That's a 1031 investor. 1031 refers to that part of the tax code having to do with tax-deferred investments. When a non-1031 investor sells a home, he has to pay capital gains on his profits, which can be substantial depending on his tax bracket. When a 1031 investor sells a home, he has to follow a strict set of rules to qualify for tax deferment. One of those rules is he has to roll over his profits, and he has 45 days to identify a property and a total of 180 days to close. If he fails to find a property in 45 days, he must pay capital gains on his proceeds. A 1031 investor running out of time can be extremely motivated and will pay thousands over market value to avoid a huge tax bill. Hi, I'm Alan Robinson, CEO and founder of Powermls. Thank you for taking the time to watch one of our sample videos. After 17 years in real estate, I can tell you it takes a lot more than a sign in the front yard to sell your own home, which is one of the biggest hurdles facing for sale by owner sellers in today's sophisticated real estate market. You don't have access to the MLS, contract software, and proper education and training. Well, that's changed with Powermls. Our goal at Powermls is to provide you the same information, education, and tools used by real estate professionals and not charge you a commission. At the heart of the Powermls system is our video library. We've produced 46 instructional videos, over 12 hours, that teach you how to price, stage, market, and show your home, how to negotiate with buyers and agents, how to professionally resolve title, appraisal, financing, and inspection issues, the nuts and bolts of any real estate purchase contract, and how to successfully make it to the closing table. We're so confident in our videos, you can watch the first few minutes of each video in our library for free. That's 46 videos and growing. Not only do we provide you professional training, our home pricing report includes recent, active, under contract, and sold listings direct from your local MLS, including pictures. The PowerMLS.com website is the most powerful for sale by owner site on the web. From your PowerMLS website, buyers can download blank contracts, property disclosures, and brochures that you upload. Also, all of our listing packages include full MLS and Realtor.com advertising and national syndication on top websites such as Homes.com, Trulia, MSN, Yahoo, AOL, HomeFinder, and Zillow. All of our premium listing packages include a 24-hour information line with lead capture technology, mobile-friendly tours, professional full-service virtual tours, and the most powerful social networking tools on the web. Put all of this together and you have Powermls, the most powerful tools, marketing, and training designed for the homeowner who's serious about selling. Our packages start at $249 and most come with a money-back guarantee. Terms and details do apply. We invite you to visit us at PowerMLS.com to find out more about the most powerful for sale by owner site on the web, or give us a call at 1-800-639-6044. I'm Alan Robinson, and thank you for watching.